Hi, Jim Rohmer. All my farmer friends out there, ETF and commodity futures traders, have a great New Year's. We really need it, the way things have been in the world these days with Ukraine and Gaza. Just do a lot of praying. Again, hope you have a great holiday weekend. This is your free weather wealth report. Make sure you download it. I actually wrote this about a week or two ago on how I called very early the easing of the northern Brazil coffee and soybean drought. Now, weather's affecting many markets. One trade alone, for example, short soybeans 2 weeks ago, or short call options and coffee, and all this hype about the drought pays for my newsletter for a few years in just a week or so, though, of course, past performance is not indicative of future results. Today, we're going to be talking about stratospheric warming, what it means for natural gas and the grain market. Two vortices, the polar vortex over the North Pole and the one over the South Pole there, those patterns affect global weather. The one over the North Pole has been sitting there for the last month and a half, not coming south, is why we've had such a warm early winter. Why potentially traders and clients in my Weather Wealth newsletter were short natural gas just under $3 a month ago. We advised taking profits earlier this week. Look at the one over the South Pole. That spinning circle there is actually called the AAO index. More of that in a moment. Okay, so right now we're going to be seeing warming aloft that's going to disrupt the northern polar vortex over the Arctic Circle. And as a result, when that happens, the vortex weakens, brings snows and cold to parts of Europe, the United States. Look at this warming 50 degrees Fahrenheit, 20 miles up in space, is going to bring colder weather and snow across much of Europe and also the US. What that means is various option ETF and future strategies. After my bearish outlook in natural gas the last month or so, we're developing new strategies in energy spreads and natural gas for clients around the world in no less than about seven or eight countries. So the polar vortex has remained over the South Pole. It's going to stay there. That's called a positive AAO index. And what happens when that remains over the South Pole is you have in my Client Predict program that looks out several months in advance, sometimes for farmers in grains and commodity traders, a wetter pattern for the month of December and probably late December, obviously here recently, but more so January and February. That's a bearish signal for corn and beans with El Nino. And the stratospheric situation going on with the polar vortex over the South Pole. From a weather perspective, this is bearish grains longer term. Will things change? Will La Niña form? How do you want to know this before anybody else changes their forecast? We advise clients quickly before maps change by using teleconnections. So, in the natural gas market, about a month and a half ago, we were bearish natural gas around $3. My spider used for grains and coffee and cocoa and all different markets, discusses global weather, discusses the anti-herd mentality. How many people are long or short a market? You go the other way sometimes, right? Pattern recognition, the charts. I did this for all markets. A minus seven 5 weeks ago is much more neutral right now and may become slightly bullish going into the middle part of January and February once we get this bearishness out of the UK market from record global supplies the last year or two and warm weather. Then it's a possibility that natural gas prices may go higher. So, stratospheric warming, okay? What happens 10 to 20 miles up in space doesn't always happen. And it's only happened in five El Nino cases since 1950. There they are, 2019, 2007, 1966, 2015. Notice how in both January, slightly colder than normal, and February, a colder weather pattern could ensue. Okay, so the Arctic is certainly a lot warmer than it was 10, 20, 30 years ago. But I believe it's definitely climate change, and in particular, the warming global oceans and deforestation. So it may not be this cold, 8, 10, 15 degrees below normal, but even slightly below normal going into mid-January and February will be enough to probably put the brakes on the natural gas market. So that's what I'm looking at right now for my clients. One trade alone could pay for my newsletter for years. We caught probably the top of the coffee market here recently and all this hype and dry weather. Have a very happy New Year. Just real quickly, by the way, this is what I got for Christmas. Bye bye, stinky feet. Bye-bye, love. But I play so much tennis that my fiance got me something for my sneakers. So hopefully we'll have a better New Year's this year. A lot of optimism. Hopefully more changes in the world coming. We really need it. Again, enjoy. Download a free issue of WeatherWealth. Have a great 2024. Take care.